keep the cork, because the cork is cool. And this you can just put away.
Hello everyone! Hola!
Don't crash my vlog.
She just destroys the opening speech every single time.
Cheers!
Welcome to another episode of the Snack Vlog. We are here in Barcelona, Spain! It is actually our final night tonight, and so we just decided at the last minute to do a snack vlog. So we will be trying out a few rather ordinary chips. But the challenge here was, I went down to the grocery and I picked out snacks that are 1 euro or less. So this is what I got here. I only got 4 snacks, which we will be trying tonight. Time check, it is actually midnight already. We had to wait until everybody went to sleep so we could try this one, so you know, there's not a lot of noise. Anyway, so for this special vlog, aside from this vlog crasher over here, I have also invited another special guest. She is also an aspiring vlogger, and she is one of my cousins. Well, she was actually gonna join us in our first snack vlog, but goodness knows what happened to her, why she never showed up. Anyway, so let's give a big round of applause to our special guest.
Hola.
So this is Nicole. She also wants to be a vlogger. We've been here in Spain for how many days now?
4 days?
Five or six days. We're actually here to attend a wedding. It is her sister's wedding. It was actually yesterday, and I still have my bridal hairdo. Anyway,
from last night. She's...
Did you just take a drink?
She had that hairdo for 24 hours.
It's very nice. Anyway, so she wants to be a vlogger too, but I think she only found out on this trip how hard it was to be a vlogger.
Right?
Yeah.
Why was it hard? Because you have to like stop every second to take the perfect shot and all that.
Seriously, I don't understand. I really don't understand how vloggers do it. Right. So ever since I created this channel, on this Spain trip, I also tried to be a travel vlogger. But like she said, it was really very, very hard. You know, usually I have a lot of things to say. I'm a very talkative person, right? She's also very talkative. But it's just so hard to walk around with your phone or your camera always like that, you know, and you always have to talk. For me, seriously, again, I don't understand how travel vloggers do it. How do they enjoy the moment?
Yeah, exactly.
I mean, you see something beautiful, and it's like, oh, get the camera. Oh my God, we better capture it for the vlog, right?
You have to add up some comments as well when you're traveling, and that's really hard.
Exactly. You tried vlogging on the plane, right?
Yeah.
I took her camera. Well, I didn't exactly take her camera, but her camera was out here in the living room, and I was like, let me just go through a couple of her photos. And then I came across a video of her on the plane ride over, and she was like vlogging. How did you feel at that time when you were doing that?
I had to retake a lot of shots.
Really?
Yeah. Because it was hard, like I didn't know if I was in the right angle, and then if I was saying the right words. So I had to like retake and retake.
Oh my God. Anyway, so
Yes? I started my channel. It's been a very easy and fun job crashing my rival's channel, you know?
Well, and who is your rival channel?
My channel is the rival channel of foodreview.
She just wants to crash.
And vlogging is actually fun.
Vlogging is actually fun.
Just
really.
Talking to the audience. Nice. Like video journal.
Video journal. You realize the camera can see you scratching yourself right now, right? It's so beautiful, scratching yourself. You scratch your back, it's also gonna scratch your nose, okay? That's gonna be very ugly. Again, it's like 12 midnight right now. I think I should just send her to bed, because otherwise she won't be able to sleep. Anyway, I discovered this rather cool looking...
Disgusting, by the way.
Moscato in the grocery store, and it's color blue. It's just quite fascinating. Anyway, so let's just put that there. As I've mentioned, I went down to the store and I I make sure to pick out snacks that are 1 euro or less. What do you think we should start with first?
I want to start with this.
She wants the pizza. Pizza Angel, please give it to me. Okay, so this is the mini pizza. Alright, you can read it out first. What is it?
A mini pizza.
Just read it, what does that say?
Pecho al corno.
Okay, so let's open it up. You know how to open it, right?
Yeah.
Because the last time, if you've seen the last vlog, Selena, my other special guest, she opened the bag right down here. Oh, look at that! She did it! Okay.
I'll take the first bite.
Okay, so don't forget we are rating this from 1 to 5, okay? 1 to 5, 1's the lowest, 5 is the highest. No 1.1, 1.2, okay? It's just 1 to 5, alright?
Hey, go. You're on camera.
Hi, camera.
What? I like it.
I can hear it as soon as you bite into it. It seems very crunchy.
I do taste the pizza flavor in it with a little...
Oh.
It's a little what?
With a little of... Is the taste like familiar to you?
Yeah, it does.
What do you think?
It's like pizza chip.
That's all. What does it taste like?
I think
like how would you explain it to someone who's not had pizza before? Rival channel?
Mm-hmm. Oh. Like, imagine bread or some type of pastry with tomato, cheese, and whatever stuff you'd like to add on pizza. And imagine all of that compressed into one chip and eating it.
So
that is your pizza chip.
Okay, so I'm imagining this with ham and beef and all kinds of meat.
Yeah.
So you like it?
Yeah, I do.
So you like it?
Yes.
Yes.
Is it a bit too crunchy?
Too crunchy. For me, I'm not sure if I like it. It tastes ordinary. For me, it tastes like ordinary crackers. It doesn't taste like pizza crackers. Alright, so let's rate it.
Rate it 1, 2, or 5.
Rate it
1, 2, or 5. She said 1, 2, 5.
1, 2, 5.
I'll give it a 3 out of 5 stars.
1, 2, or 5. Would you eat this again?
Probably if someone gave it to me. But I wouldn't buy it in the store.
Alright. How about you?
2.
2?
2, why 2?
It is good, but I won't like get it every time I go to the store.
Okay, alright. For me, I'll give it a 1. Again, it just tastes ordinary crackers. It doesn't taste like...
delicious!
And you gave it a 2!
Either 1, 2, or 5. 5 is too much, 1 is too little, 2 is just...
3 is just perfect, average. Yeah, so what?
1, 2, 5.
Okay. Alright. Okay, let's try this one first. Let's wash down the taste. Cheers. This one I like. So what next? This time I will let Abel choose.
Cardboard.
Tastes like cardboard.
Really?
You've tasted cardboard before? I taste tasted something familiar on the second bite. What do you think?
Good.
Really? Again? Good.
Doesn't taste like cardboard.
Okay. Let me see if Nicole agrees.
Doesn't taste like cardboard.
Okay, so the first
car tires or window panes or tin foil or
something. So you tasted all of that?
I said definitely.
Anyway, let's see if Nicole agrees with me, okay? So the first bite I thought was quite plain, quite ordinary, very bland taste. But the second bite I had actually started to taste like the most basic Pringles.
Yeah, the original one.
Yes, no, it doesn't taste like that.
Could you like taste it on the first try or?
Mm. Or it just came after? It came after. Mm. But it tastes weirder than the Pringles.
What does that mean, weirder? Like it's not good? Or,
yeah,
or
not
like
good.
A fake Pringle?
Yeah, yeah. If they were to imitate a Pringles, this would be it.
Well, how would you rate it?
Negative one is a lot.
Negative one. Okay. How about you?
Five.
Really? For me, I would rate it.
Delicious. Company make more and send it to my copy.
Really? For me, I would rate it a 4. I rate it a 4 because sometimes when I'm hungry for snacks but not too sure what I want to eat, I usually look for snacks that have very, very neutral, very boring, very bland taste. So for that, I would give this a 4. This would be a good snack for me if I am feeling, again, if I'm feeling hungry for snacks but don't want to eat.
Okay, 4. Patata
steak. So this is... How do you pronounce this again? Savor, lemon, and pimenta.
Do it again.
Patatas, fritas, savor, lemon, and pimenta.
Okay,
so I bought this because I thought, you know, it looks quite interesting because I like the black packaging. It looks quite elegant, I thought. So, savor, lemon, and pimienta. What do you think that is? It's got, well, obviously lemon is lemon. What do you think that pimienta is?
Pepper?
Judging from the... Oh, I think it's that thing right there.
Cabbage. Yeah.
Brown pepper?
I'm not sure it's brown pepper. Okay.
It's also gluten-free.
Mm-hmm. Okay, gluten-free.
Okay.
passing down the loop.
We apologize if we pronounce any of these wrong.
Yes. And just to let you know, this vlog is not sponsored by this company. Okay, so let us try these chocolate balls. It looks like crunch, right?
Yeah.
Crunch. Okay. Alright. Smells like chocolate.
One caramel.
Hazelnut chocolate or just chocolate? I got two.
You got two. So gritty.
It does smell like crunch too. Very, very easy to bite into. Mm-hmm. I expected it to be more hard.
Cheese ball with chocolate around.
Yeah, yeah. Does it taste like a snack in the Philippines?
It looks like something similar to it.
Like pillows?
It does not have like a pillow snack in the Philippines. What do you think?
It's
like chocolate, that's all. Tastes like chocolate. I expected it to be more hazelnut, crunchy, chocolate snack.
So what do you think, Eva?
It's alright, I won't really eat it that much.
Hmm. Maybe we should have drank some water first before we tried this, right? Yeah, I'm not too sure about this one too. I feel like
it's stuck in your teeth.
I think that this is more of a snack for younger kids. I think like for them, they will like this, they'll enjoy it. Not for me though, I mean, I usually like chocolate snacks, but for this one, it's a no for me. I had a little bit of a shock because I expected it to be quite hard. So I like sort of used the force of my teeth to just, you know, clamp down on it, only to find that it was quite soft. So that was a weird sensation. So,
rate? I'd give it a 2.
Too.
Only because it has chocolate flavor in it, and I like chocolate.
You?
Ariel?
That's PM.
Okay, Ariel.
He says 1.
Okay, and you?
1.
1? Okay, I give it a 1 as well. Sorry, Hasendado, but yeah, I think this would be more popular with the younger kids, younger than her. Okay, so those are all the 4 snacks that we have tried. We have tried the pizza snack, we've tried the patata chips, we've tried the choco balls, and we've tried this lemon and pimienta. Okay, so I think it's not bad, right? For Spanish snacks and Spanish vlogs, how do you feel? So this is like your first snack vlog, right? So how do you feel about it? Do you feel comfortable or
nervous?
Yeah,
I feel comfortable. I like
she
it.
She likes food as well. She feels comfortable.
It's okay. I like the snacks here, especially that it's different from Macau. So it's good to always taste something different.
So what do you think of the snacks here?
The chips. The 2 big chips are really nice, the pizza chips not as much, and the chocolate balls. Kind of disappointing.
Disappointing, you see? Hasendado, this is very, very disappointing. Okay, so that is it for today's snack vlog. We hope that you enjoyed watching this one in a different setting in Spain. Okay, so everybody, let us say good night.
Good night!
Good night from Spain, Barcelona. Do not forget to subscribe, subscribe, and subscribe. Goodbye!